Individuals shall be required to pay tax at the reduced rate of 10% for income between 5 lakhs to 7.5 lakhs against the prevailing 20%. So anyone who's earning between 5 to 7.5 lakhs, sir, today pays 20%. We are now reducing it in the new regime, which is devoid of exemptions, to 10% only. So 20% comes down to 10%. Sir, the next example. For income between 7.5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, I earlier said about 5 to 7.5, now I'm saying about 7.5 to 10 lakhs. So for income between 7.5 lakh to 10 lakh, he or she will pay at the reduced rate of 15% only against the current prevailing 20%. Sir, similarly, for the income between 10 lakhs to 12.5 lakhs, presently the tax is 30%. For income between 10 lakh to 12.5 lakh, the present prevailing rate is 30%. That is now being brought down to 20% only. Sir, the income between, I spoke about 10 to 12.5 lakhs. Now, 12.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs will be taxed. At the moment, 12.5 to 15 lakhs is taxed at 30%. Now, those earning between 12.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs will be charged at 25% only. Sir, incomes above 15 lakhs will be continued at 30%, but no exemptions at all. Those earning up to 5 lakhs shall not pay any tax either in the old regime or in the new regime. Medium and small and micro enterprises, the MSMEs, currently, businesses having turnover of more than 1 crore rupees are required to get their books of accounts audited by an accountant. In order to reduce the compliance burden on small retailers, traders, shopkeepers who comprise the MSME sector, I propose to raise by 5 times the turnover threshold for audit from the existing 1 crore to 5 crore. So up to 5 crore, there wouldn't be a requirement for auditing of their accounts. Further, in order to boost less cash economy, I propose that the increased limit shall apply only to those businesses which carry out less than 5% of their businesses and business transactions in cash. So we wish to move to greater digitization. 150 higher education institutions will start apprenticeship embedded degree diploma courses by March 2021. The government proposes to start a program whereby urban local bodies across the country would provide internship opportunities to fresh engineers for a period up to 1 year. So local bodies, as you know, do undertake a lot of public work program, and their manpower is also limited. But yet, young engineers who are ready to serve for the purpose of learning how it is to work with the government are also going around seeking opportunities. So here we have created an opportunity by saying urban local bodies should now give opportunity for fresh engineers so that they can help them plan better and in turn also learn as an intern under the local bodies. So this is for a period of 1 year that we've opened up. In order to provide quality education to students of deprived section of the society as well as those who do not have access to higher education, it is proposed to start a degree level full-fledged online education program. This shall be offered only by institutions who are ranked within top 100 in the National Institutional Ranking Framework. Initially, only a few such institutions would be asked to offer such programs. Sir, India should also be a preferred destination for higher education. Hence, under its Study in India program, an IND SAT exam is proposed to be held in Asian and African countries. It shall be used for benchmarking foreign candidates who receive scholarships for studying in Indian higher education centers. A national police university and a national forensic science university are being proposed in the domain of policing science, forensic science and cyber forensics. There is a shortage of medical doctors. There is a shortage of qualified medical doctors, both general practitioners as well as specialists. In order to meet this requirement, it is proposed to attach a medical college to an existing district hospital in PPP mode. Those states that fully allow facilities of the hospital to the medical college and wish to provide land at a concession would be able to receive viability gap funding from the center. Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, no dispute but only trust scheme. If I can say it in English, no dispute but trust scheme. Vivad Se Vishwas scheme. Sir, in the past, our government has taken several measures to reduce tax litigations. In the last budget, Sabka Vishwas scheme was brought in to reduce litigation in indirect taxes. It resulted in settling over 1,89,000 cases. Currently, there are 4,83,000 direct tax cases. 4,83,000 direct tax cases pending in various appellate forums, Commissioner of Appeals, Income Tax Appellate Tribunal, High Court, Supreme Court, and so on. This year, I propose to bring a scheme similar to the indirect tax Sabka Vishwas scheme for reducing the litigation even in the direct taxes. Under the proposed Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, a taxpayer would be required to pay only the amount of disputed tax and will get complete waiver of interest and penalty provided he pays by 31st March 2020. Those who avail this scheme after 31st March 2020 will have to pay some additional amount, but even then they can come in. The scheme will remain open till 30th June 2020. So the first thing is 31st March 2020, where you just pay the disputed tax amount, no penalty, no interest. In case you don't do it before that, you move over to 30th June, but where you pay some additional amount. Taxpayers in whose cases appeals are pending at any level can benefit from this scheme. I hope that taxpayers will make use of this opportunity to get relief from vexatious litigation processes.